In this video, we're going to solve a question from the German Math Olympiad. The question is, determine all prime numbers P for which the system P plus 1 equals 2x squared and P squared plus 1 equals 2y squared has the solution in integers x and y. Then how to solve it? Because we try to solve for P, and it doesn't matter x and y positive or negative, x squared and y squared are always positive. So we're going to do this. Without loss of generality, we can assume both x and y are bigger than or equal to 0. So now let's see what information we get from the two equations. First, let's look at the first equation. Then from the first equation, p plus 1 equals 2x squared. Because the right-hand side, 2x squared, is even. So that means the left-hand side is also even number. So here, p plus 1 is even. That means p cannot be an even number. So that means p cannot be 2. So p must be a prime number bigger than 2. That is the first result. So now let's see the first equation again. Okay, so then from the first equation, so here 2x squared equals p plus 1. Because p is a prime number bigger than 2, so p is less than p squared, then less than p squared plus 1. So now let's see p squared plus 1 equals 2y squared. So then here, just equals 2y squared. So you see we have 2x squared is less than 2y squared. So that implies x is less than y. So then here, we have x is less than y. So we can label this one as result 1. So now let's look at the equation 2. So then here's the equation 2. So then for this equation 2, so we're going to put a 2y squared. So then equation 2 is a 2y squared equals p squared plus 1. Then less than p squared plus p squared. Because y is less than p squared. P is a prime number bigger than 2. So then this one equals 2p squared. So you see we have 2y squared is less than 2p squared. So that implies y is less than p. Then here, just y is less than p. So then this is the second result. So now let's put the result 1 and the result 2 together. So then you see we have x less than y, then y less than p. So now let's see, put the result 1 with the result 2 together. So then we have this result. So that's x is less than y, then less than p. So then we put this one as the result 3. Okay, so now let's look at the two equations. So here are the two equations. Because we try to solve for p, then we notice, you see here, so then if second equation minus first equation, so then we have 1, 1 canceled, then we have p squared minus p. Then it's divisible by p. So we can start from here. Second equation minus the first equation and see where it takes us. So now let's see. So let's do the second equation minus first equation. Then here, just second equation, that's 2y squared minus 2x squared. We're going to start from the right-hand side. So here, minus here. Then for the left-hand side, then we have p squared plus 1, then minus p plus 1. So now let's simplify here. So 1 and 1 canceled. So then here we have p squared minus p. So then this one is divisible by P. So that means it has a remainder 0 once it's divided by P. So then this implies, so this part, so this implies 2y squared minus 2x squared has a remainder 0 once it's divided by P, or is divisible by P. So now let's take out the common factor 2. So then inside we have y squared minus x squared, so factor y squared minus x squared, so here just y minus x, then here y plus x, then has a remainder 0, y is divided by p. Okay, so now let's look at the result 3. Based on this result 3, see, so here by result 3, that's x less than y less than p. So based on result 3, so that means y minus x. That means y minus x is also less than p. What that means, so that means y minus x is not divisible by p because it's less than p. Okay, so now let's look at the 2. Because at the very beginning, we identified p is not equal to 2. So because p is a prime number bigger than p. So what that means? So that means 2 is also not divisible by p. So this implies only y plus x is divisible by p. So then we have this conclusion. So that means y plus x has a remainder 0. 1 divided by p. Okay, so since y plus x is bigger than 0, based on result 3, see, x less than y less than p, so that means here, so then less than y plus y. So x is less than y. So then this one equals 2y. Because y is less than p, so this one less than 2p. So what that means, you see here, so we have x plus y, y plus x is bigger than y, but less than 2p. But y plus x is divisible by p. What that means? So that means y plus x just equals 1p. Then we got this result. So now we have, since we have two equations with three variables, see here, so we have two equations, but with three variables. So then we want to reduce the number of variables. So now let's solve this one for y. And here, solve for y. Then we have just y equals p minus x. So now we're going to use the equation 2, so this equation 2. So we're going to use p minus x to replace y here. So reduce the number of variables. Because right now we have variables, three variables, x, y, and p. We want to reduce one. Okay, so now let's see. Then here, just write down the equation 2. So here, just p squared plus 1, then equals 2y squared. Then for 2y squared, so for y, use a p minus x, replace it. So then p minus x squared. Then expand this part. So then we have 2, and here inside, p squared minus 2px plus x squared. So then multiply each term by 2. And here, just 2p squared minus 4px plus 2x squared. Then for this part, for 2x squared, so look at the first equation. First equation, we have 2x squared equals p plus 1. So we're going to use a p plus 1 to replace this part. So then here, this equals 2p squared minus 4px in here plus p plus 1. So now you see we have p squared plus 1 equals this part. So let's write down the result. In here, so we have p squared plus 1 equals 2p squared minus 4px plus p plus 1. Then 1 and 1 canceled, so then move p squared to other side. Then here, just p squared minus 4px plus p equals 0. Take out the common factor p, then p times p minus 4x plus 1 equals 0. Because p is a prime number, so p cannot be 0. So that means this part equals 0. Then here, just p minus 4x plus 1 equals 0. So then p equals 4x minus 1. So now let's label this result. So now you see we have an equation with two variables. So now we still want to reduce the variable to 1. So now let's see, because here we have x. So now let's see the first equation. See, this is the first equation. So 2x squared equals p plus 1. So we're going to use a 4x minus 1 replace p here. So now let's see here. Then from the equation 1, so we have 2x squared equals p plus 1. Then use 4x plus 1 minus 1 replace p. Then here, just 4x minus 1, then plus 1. Then negative 1, positive 1 canceled. So then we have 2x squared, which equals 4x. Then cancel out the 2, then we have x squared minus 2x equals 0. Then take out the common factor x, then here x minus 2 equals 0. Then x equals 0 or x equals 2. Because our purpose is to solve for p, so we can use this result. So now let's write down this part. So then p equals 4x minus 1. Then based on the result, p equals 4x minus 1. Then when x equals 0, when x equals 0, so 0 put here, so we have a p equals negative 1. Because p is a prime number, cannot be negative 1. So this is not right. So now let's see x equals 2. So when x equals 2, then use a 2 to replace x here. So then we have p equals 7. 7 is a prime number. So then we have the solution for p. So p is only prime number. P equals 7 is only prime number for the system equation. So it has integer solutions. Thanks for watching.